Yes, dear students, a very good morning to all of you. I hope all of you are strong and safe at your homes. Today I am going to teach you the poem entitled The Road Not Taken of 9th class. Dear students, it is a very simple poem. The poet Robert Frost is famous in English poetry for writing these kinds of poems. We have read many other poems also by Robert Frost. The title of the poem is Road Not Taken. So dear students, we are going to read the poem. There are four stanzas in this poem. In the first stanza, the poet says, two roads diverge in a yellow wood, and sorry, I could not travel both and be one traveler, long I stood and I looked down one edge for edge I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. So in this stanza, the poet is telling us that one day he was trailing through a forest. And when he reached to the forest, dense forest, the road was diverse, means divided in two parts. One road was leading to left side and other was right side. Naturally, it so happens many times that when the roads are divided, we cannot decide which way should we take at this time. So when the poet says that when he reached to the forest, the road was divided into two ways, two parts, and he could not decide that which road he should take, which path he should walk on. Two roads diverge in yellow wood. Yellow wood means the wood, the jungle was full with flower plants. That is why he calls the wood yellow wood. Meaning I have already underlined and you have to read the underlined words and you have to learn the underlined word, meaning of the underlined words. And sorry, I could not travel both. The poet says that he was very sorry because he was not certain that which road should he take. And he could not walk he could not travel both the roads at a time. एक समय में दोनों रास्तों पर तो नहीं चल सकता था. And be one traveler, and as he was alone, there was nobody with him, there was none else with him. Long I stood, the poet says that I had to stand for a long time there to decide, and I looked down one as far as I could to where it went in the undergrowth. The poet says that he could not decide which path, which road he should walk on, and to decide that he looked down on the first road as far as he could. जितनी दूर वो देख सका उसने देखा. As far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Bent means turned. The poet says that I saw on the road up to the distance where it turned to a side. जहां ये मूर्ति थी वहां तक मैंने देखा. तो इट इज वेरी सिंपल स्टेंजा. एंड इन दी फर्स्ट स्टेंजा यू हैव रीड दैट द पोएट वॉज एलोन एंड ही वॉज ट्रेवलिंग इन द फॉरेस्ट एंड द रोड वॉज डिवाइडेड इंटू टू रोड्स एंड ही वॉज अनसर्टेन. ही कुड नॉट decide which path he should take at that time. Here road not taken means choice. Next stanza hai, then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. In the next stanza, the poet is telling us that there was no difference between the two roads. Then took the other just as fair. Which road did he decide to walk on? The poet says that after thinking for some time, he reached a conclusion. He decided to walk on the other road. And what kind of road it was? It was as fair as the first. इतनी fair थी जितनी की पहले थी. And having perhaps the better claim, and it was perhaps the better than the first because it was grassy and wanted view. Why did the poet tells us that it was a better road? Because it was grassy, covered with green grass, and wanted wear means few people had walked on the road first. पहले बहुत कम लोगों के द्वारा, it was less used, बहुत ही कम इसको use की गई थी पहले, and it was covered with green grass. Though as for that the passing there, जहां तक उस पर गुजरने का सवाल है, had warned them really about the same. Warn means होता है घिसना. It means कि घिसी हुई इतनी थी जितनी की
मतलब द कंडीशन ऑफ द टू रॉग वॉज सेम, देर वॉज नॉट मच डिफरेंस बिटवीन देम एंड द पोएट सेज दैट ही हैड डिसाइडेड टू वॉक ऑन द अदर रोड. And in the third stanza, the poet says, "And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden back. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how we leads on the way, I doubted if I should ever come back." This is very important stanza, and as I have already told you that here road taken, raaste ka chunna kar matlab making choices, having choices. Ki when we, our choices are always right, but we always think we pine for means wish. For the right choice, हम हमेशा सोचते हैं कि हमने जो चुनाव किया वो सही नहीं था और हम आगे जो चुनाव करेंगे वो बढ़िया रहेगा. And both that morning equally lay, what was the condition? वो कमोबेश वही जो इस स्टेंजा में वही इसका है क्या कि what was the condition of the both the roads at that time? Both the that morning equally lay means equally lay in leaves, no step had traveled back. Both the roads were covered with leaves and they were laid equally, samanantar thi. Both the roads were covered with the leaves and oh, I kept the first for another day. Kept means thought. As I have already told you that we pine for the right choice. We always pine for the right choice, but we never thinks that the choice we have already make is right. Oh, I kept for the first for another day. The poet says that both the roads were covered with leaves, and I thought that I will use the first road some another day, because in the first stanza, in the second stanza we read that he had chosen the second road for to travel that at that time, and in this stanza he is telling us is that he wished to walk on that road for some other day. Yet knowing how way leads on the way, I doubted if I should ever come back here. We always remain in doubt that our choice is wrong, and we always remain in doubt that if we will be able to come on this path अगेन और नॉट. हम इस रास्ते पर कभी दोबारा आ सकेंगे या नहीं चल सकेंगे, इस बात के बारे में हमेशा हमें डाउट रहता है. एंड वी ऑलवेज रिमेन डाउटफुल अबाउट अवर चॉइसेस. रिपोर्ट सेज आई केप्ट द फर्स्ट फॉर अनदर डे, इट मीन्स आई डिसाइडेड. द पोएट सेज दैट ही डिसाइडेड टू यूज द फर्स्ट रोड to some on some another day. Yet knowing how way leads on the way, I doubted if I should ever come back. The poet says that although he knew very well about the road, but he doubted. Usse sandeh tha ki if he would be able to come on the road again or not. कि वो दोबारा आ सकेगा या नहीं आ सकेगा. तो वी ऑलवेज रिमेन अनसर्टेन मूड. वी आर But the conclusion of the poem is that we must always remain sure that the choice we have made, जो हमने रास्ता चुना है, the way we have chosen is right, and the way we are walking upon, जिस रास्ते पे हम चल रहे हैं, that is right. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Sigh means satisfaction, contentment means santushti. I shall be telling this with a sigh somewhere ages and ages hence. Hence means future ages. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. The poet says that he will be able to tell the future generation with satisfaction that one day he was traveling alone in the forest somewhere ages and ages hence comes. He will be able to tell the future generation that one day he was traveling alone in the forest, and the road was divided in two ways, and he decided to walk on the first road, which was less traveled by means वो बहुत ही कम यूज की गई थी, मतलब इट वॉज ही चूज ए न्यू पथ, ही मेड ए फ्रेश चॉइस इट मीन्स, एंड दैट हैज मेड ऑल द डिफरेंसेस. And it that had made all the differences. इससे बहुत सारी क्या है कि फर्क पड़ गई. तो dear students, in this lesson we have read, it is very simple poem, and the poet Robert Frost always writes on these kinds of subjects. This is a philosophical poem. And during the examinations, you are always asked the questions, answers from the poems. So, the first question is, why did the first question? Now, dear students, we have read this poem, and we shall answer these questions. The first question is, why did the poet stand long? The answer is that poet stood long because he was traveling alone in the forest, and the road was divided into two parts, and he could not decide that which road he should walk on. That is why the poet stood long. Which road was taken by the poet? The road was diverged or divided into two parts, but the poet chose the road which was less used. और इसमें से ऐसे कर सकते हो, the poet chose the road which was less used. Why did the poet choose the other road? मिलता जुलता क्वेश्चन है. Because he made a new choice. क्यों उसने दूसरी रोड चुनी. द पोएट चूज द अदर रोड बिकॉज इट वॉज कवर्ड विथ ग्रीन ग्रास. इट वॉज नॉट ट्रोडन बाय. इट वॉज लेस यूज्ड. सो ही चूज दैट रोड. वेयर वॉज द वट वॉज द कंडीशन ऑफ बोथ द रोड्स. तो वेरी सिंपल. बोथ द रोड्स वर कवर्ड विद लीव्स एंड ग्रीन ग्रास एंड बोथ द रोड्स वर पैरेलल और इक्वल इन डिस्टेंस. जो भी इनकी दो समानताएं आपको यू हैव टू राइट टू स्पेशल क्वालिटीज ऑफ द रोड्स. व्हाट डिड द पोएट डिसाइड रिगार्डिंग द फर्स्ट रोड. फर्स्ट रोड के बारे में क्या. द पोएट डिसाइडेड रिगार्डिंग द फर्स्ट रोड दैट ही वुड यूज द फर्स्ट रोड सम टाइम अगेन इन ए लाइफ. एज वी हैव रीड अगेन एंड अगेन दिस पोएम दैट वी चूज ए पथ बट वी पाइंट फॉर एनोदर. हम एक रास्ता चुन लेते हैं और दूसरे रास्ते की आशा करते रहते हैं. बट हाँ व्हाट डिड द पोएट डिसाइड रिगार्डिंग द फर्स्ट रोड. उसका उत्तर क्या होगा. द पोएट डिसाइडेड रिगार्डिंग द फर्स्ट रोड that he wanted to walk on the first roads on some time else in his life. या ऐसे भी कह सकते हो he wished to walk on the road in his life some other time. What did the poet doubt? क्या डाउट था. इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है. बिकॉज वी हैव रीड द कंक्लूजन ऑफ द पोएम इज दैट वी मेक ए चॉइस इन अवर लाइफ बट वी ऑलवेज डाउट दैट वी मस्ट मेक अनदर चॉइस इन अवर लाइफ. जो भी रास्ता हम चुनते हैं उसके बारे में हमें डाउट रहता है कि हमने जो रास्ता चुना है वो ठीक नहीं है और हम दूसरा रास्ता चुनेंगे. तो ये व्हाट डिड द पोएट डाउट. द पोएट डाउटेड अबाउट हिज चॉइस अबाउट हिज अबाउट द पथ अबाउट द रोड विच ही हैड चूजन एंड ही विश्ड ही वांटेड टू नो दैट he wanted to know that what will be the difference when he would walk on the first road in his life in future. kya farak aayega jab pehle road pe pehle raste pe dobara chalega aur abhi jo raste pe chala hai isme. matlab he wanted to know the difference between the results of walking on the both the roads both the paths. एंड लास्ट क्वेश्चन इज एक्सप्लेन द फिलोसफी हिडन इन द पोएम. इट इज क्वेश्चन जो पूछा जाता है कि राइट द थीम ऑफ द पोएम फिलोसफी हिडन इन द पोएम. तो आंसर विल बी सेम. द आंसर ऑफ द क्वेश्चन इज दैट ह्यूमन बींग वी ह्यूमन बींग मेक चॉइसेस एंड our every choice is somewhat right but we always remain in doubt. We always remain doubtful that our choice is not right and we pine for we wish to make another choice in our life. But all the paths all the roads आर राइट. सारे रास्ते सही होते हैं सारे रास्ते ठीक होते हैं. वी मस्ट ऑलवेज मेक ए चॉइस एंड वी मस्ट डू अवर ड्यूटीज वेल। तो प्रिय बच्चों, मैंने आपको आज जो पोएम पढ़ाई, द रोड नॉट टेकन बाई अवर फ्रॉस्ट, की कौन सा रास्ता कवि ने चुना, विच रोड द पोएट हैड चूजन एंड विच रोड डिड ही वॉन्ट टू वॉक ऑन इन फ्यूचर इन हिज लाइफ। तो यू हैव टू राइट द मीनिंग्स ऑफ द पोएम, यू हैव टू राइट एंड लर्न द क्वेश्चन ऑफ द पोएम, एंड एज आई टेल यू डेली दैट बाई रनिंग ऑनलाइन क्लासेस व्हाट इज अवर एम, वी वॉन्ट टू कीप यू एंगेज्ड इन योर स्टडी, वी वॉन्ट दैट यू कैन मेक बेस्ट यूज योर टाइम। तो आई होप दैट यू विल लर्न दिस पॉइंट, यू विल लर्न ऑल द मीनिंग्स एंड यू विल स्टे एट योर होम, स्टे एट योर स्टडी रूम एंड स्टे सेफ। थैंक यू वेरी मच।